Tomatoes are everyone's favorite garden vegetable, but sometimes we have some competition for the fruits in the garden. And one of the problems that you may notice in your garden is blossom end rot on tomatoes. Now, this can occur when soil moisture fluctuates dramatically. Calcium uptake is slow in plants. When the fluctuation of water make it unavailable to the plants, you can get this sunken brown spot on the blossom end of the fruit. It's best to go ahead and pull any affected fruit off and don't let the plant try to mature those and save its energy for further fruit. It's not a problem to put those fruit in the compost pile. Blossom end rot, it can be a calcium deficiency problem, but calcium deficiency is actually pretty rare in our Austin soils. Gypsum can be added if calcium is low, and you can fertilize your plants with comfrey and eggshells to give a minor application of calcium to the plants. And foliar sprays with seaweed may help also if the problem persists, but mulch is actually the best way to help moderate soil moisture. Don't put it close to the stems, and avoid having too much nitrogen or magnesium fertilizers because that can contribute to the blocking of calcium. Similar looking black spots on areas other than the bottom of the fruit are probably early blight, and those affected fruits should be removed and destroyed. Now, cracking and cat facing are other issues that can be a result of inconsistent watering and too much nitrogen. The skin expands like a stretch mark. Here's a fruit that's almost ripe, and then when we have a heavy rain, the fruit just splits. You can eat the fruits and cut away the cracks on plants, but if you have a heavy rain and you've got fruit that are almost ready like these, just pick those and allow them to ripen indoors. So that way they won't crack. Now, sometimes you'll go out to the garden and you'll see stems that just appear to have all of the leaves stripped off. There's no leaf inside on a stem, typically toward the top of the plant. Look for black droppings and then a big green caterpillar called the tomato hornworm. Just handpick those caterpillars. If you see a caterpillar that has white cocoons on it, those are the larval stage of a braconid wasp, a beneficial wasp. So leave those in the garden because you'll have lots more beneficial wasps in the garden. Sometimes you'll see downward curling leaves or puckered leaves, and those are usually the result of aphid damage. And aphids and many other insects can transmit diseases to your plants, so it's important to get those under control. Aphids are easily controlled with a strong blast of water, not enough to damage the leaves, but just a good spray of water, also soaps and seaweed sprays. Sometimes you'll see leaf miners creating tunnels in your leaves. They have little trails that just look like they're tracings on the leaf. You can pick and destroy the affected leaves, put them in a plastic bag and put them in the garbage. If the damage is not severe, treat with neem oil if you see a lot of damage and a lot of affected leaves. Flea beetles will give you tiny little holes throughout the plant. Not usually a problem, more of a cosmetic issue, but if you have a lot of them, you might want to consider adding beneficial nematodes to your garden to help keep those under control for future garden seasons. Now, spider mite damage is something that we start to see as the temperatures get really warm and plants can be a little bit drought stress. Leaves will look spotty yellow or bronzed. You may see webbing with severe infestations. You can control it by water blasting the leaves, gentle water sprays with fogging nozzle. Neem and seaweed also can help to keep spider mites under control. Making sure your plants are well mulched, though, is a great way to keep the spider mites at bay. Now, another thing that we see a lot of are stink bugs, and they cause dimpling and sunken spots on the fruit, and it can really affect the flavor. They also can affect our pepper plants and eggplant, too. The stink bugs are fairly easy to control by sucking them up with a vacuum. You can get little hand vacuums like this and just suck the insects up. And it's pretty simple to do. I sucked up all of these bugs in just a very short time in my garden yesterday. Now, remember that insects' metabolism increases as the heat of the day increases. So if you get out in the garden early in the morning or later in the evening, you can easily handpick or suck up and vacuum up the insects. But if you wait till the middle of the day, you're not going to do that. So if you'll get out and get in the garden and observe your plants and watch for insects, you'll have tomatoes for you and not for the bugs.